Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm going to create 10 cards using the August Card Kit by Simon Says Stamp. I get tons of emails and comments asking me why I haven't been posting lately, and that's because I live in Greece and I spend most of my time at the beach. If you're following me on Facebook or Instagram, you might see photos popping up from time to time. So let's start by taking a quick look on what's inside the August card kit. Of course, you get the stamp set with lots of stars and sayings. You also get a stencil with this firework and also a metal die that cuts out the inside of a star. It doesn't cut out the star actually. You also get two mini distress ink pads and many 6x6 pattern papers. You get many of those white ones, and you will see that they are embossed with beautiful designs, and this embossing resists distress ink as well as watercolor. And here is Ginger, who was curious to see what was inside the kit as well. And you also get the craft 6x6 papers. Again, they are embossed. And also you get pattern papers, 6x6 pattern papers, and you can see that they are mainly in blue, white and red. Beautiful designs, and they are double-sided. You also get four cardstocks, one red, one blue and two whites, and just because I am creating my card bases out of them, I'm going to add one more from my stash to create 10 card bases. So let's start with card number one. I am using this pattern paper and I'm going to cut out a rectangle, and inside I have die cut the star. So you can see now that it doesn't cut out a star actually, but rather those stripes. I am going to place that on top of my card base, but before I'm going to white emboss the sentiment. So I'm preparing my paper, and then I'm going to decide with what sentiment I'm going to go. I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink, apply my white embossing powder and heat set it. For my sentiment, I have combined two of the phrases in the stamp set, and first I have stamped "You are a star," and then I have stamped "Keep shining bright." To stick this panel or my card base, I am going to use some foam squares at the back to add a little bit of dimension, and I'm going to center it at the white card base. So let's go on and make the second card. For the second card, I'm going to use this craft embossed pattern paper. I'm going to cut out a rectangle, and I am going to make sure that I get four of the designs from that pattern paper. I am planning to die cut the star at the center, but I will do it later on. For now, I am going to add a little bit of distress ink. I'm combining two different colors just so the card doesn't look so flat. And by doing this technique, you will see that all those beautiful patterns on the paper just pop up. Now, I am going to die cut the star at the center of this paper. So I'm placing it, making sure that it's not going to move with a post-it tape. And now I am going to create a shaker card out of it. So I'm applying some tape adhesive at the back, and then I am going to stick there a piece of acetate. So you can see that there are plenty of ways to use the star. I'm going to show you three different ways on how to use it. Now I have added some foam tape around the star, and I am also adding some tiny little sequins at the center, and I have went really heavy with those just because I didn't actually want them to move, but I rather wanted to fill in the whole window. So I'm going to cover it up with a piece of blue scrap paper that I had from my stash. I am going to peel off the tape from the foam and also add a little bit of tape adhesive. And I'm going to stick it at the center of my card base. Now, if you notice, I have darkened up the edges of this card base just by using my distress ink that was included in the kit. So for the sentiment, I am going to stamp the saying on this scrap paper that I have from the previous card, and I am going to white emboss it. And if you notice, I am stamping the sentiment just between the dots. It's so thin that it fits perfectly there. So this is going to match perfectly with the card base, the color of my card base. And you will see that in this video I'm going heavy with embossing. Most of the cards do have some embossing here or there, and I don't know why, but when I was creating those 10 cards I kept getting ideas where embossing was a must. So anyway, I'm going to stick the sentiment at the center, and I am using some tiny foam squares at the back, and this is going to add a little bit of dimension on the sentiment. So this is a great masculine card. And you will see that in this kit, just because of the colors, I made many masculine cards. So let's move on to the third card. For the third card, I'm working directly on the card base, which is not something I usually do since I always love dimension. So I am going to stamp some of the stars from the stamp set. And I am going to make a nice and interesting background. I'm going to switch from the bigger stars to the smaller ones, and even the tiny ones where I am going to use to fill in the gaps. Once this is ready, I'm going to use my white embossing powder to apply it, and then I'm going to use my heat gun to heat set everything. So here is the finished result. You can leave it as it is, or you can darken it up even more by applying some distress ink. I am doing so just because I can, and because I had this mini ink pad on my card kit. Now I'm also going to combine it with a little bit of a black suit. Dark colors really help those designs to pop up. Now for the sentiment, I am going with one from the set that says, "Though we are far apart, we are sleeping under the same stars." I am going to stamp it with Versa marking on top of this vellum paper. This is thick vellum, and it doesn't get too warped when you are using your heat gun over it. I'm going to apply some white embossing powder, and once this is heat set, I'm going to cut it out in a strip of paper, wrap it around my card base, and I'm going to stick it at the back. I am going to use some regular tape adhesive for that, but if you are you don't want to see that, you can use a tape adhesive for vellum that it doesn't show. So this is the card. Let's move on to the next one. I am using this striped pattern paper, and I'm going to cut out a frame. For that I'm using the Stitched Rectangles by Simon Says Stamp. And now I'm working on this white piece of paper. I am going to emboss the stars that make this heart constellation, and I am going to apply my red embossing powder. Now if you don't have a red embossing powder or blue like I am doing and using on this card, you can just use your ink pads. Once that's done and heat set, I'm going to move on and do the sentiment. For the sentiment, I combined two of the phrases from the stamp set. I combined "When we are together" and the other one that says "I see stars." So I am going to emboss the sentiment with the blue embossing powder. And I have also stamped some more constellations around the heart. So I repeat embossing and applying my embossing powder, and you will see the finished result here. I'm applying some tape adhesive at the back of this panel. I'm going to stick it centered at this red card base. And then on top I am going to stick the frame. For the frame I have used foam squares at the back just to have it a little bit raised to add some dimension. Also notice how I have embossed a little star just next to the word star. To make it shine even more, I am using some Wink of Stella clear glitter pen. And this is going to finish off the card. For the fifth card, I am working on my red card base, and just to darken it up a little bit, I am using the distress ink that was included in the kit. I'm going around the edges, and you can see that it's not as bright as it was at the beginning. I'm also using my trusted tag die, and I'm going to cut out this tag from the pattern paper, and from this leftover from the previous cards I'm going to cut out a strip that has the stars and some stripes of white and red. I'm going to stick that at the bottom of my tag just to make it look more interesting. I always like combining my different pattern papers. And now I'm going to create some more elements for the tag. I'm going to use this craft paper from the kit, and I'm going to cut out the star. So just because this doesn't actually cut out the star, but rather creates those stripes, I am going to use my scissors and go all around it. I'm making sure that I leave a good quarter of an inch. And once this is ready, I will have an extra element to stick on my card. Now, to do the sentiment, I use the same technique. So I am going to stamp the sentiment on some white pattern paper, and then I am going to use the scissors to cut it out. So this way I am creating different elements as embellishments to stick on top of my tag. I am using my paper trimmer to cut out the half of this at the top and at the bottom, and then I am going to use my scissors to cut around the word star, making sure that it looks as if it is a sticker. So I am leaving just a hair of white all around the word. If you're not feeling confident that you can do it directly with your scissors, just use a pencil, draw a piercing line, and just follow your drawing. So now that I have all the elements ready, it's time to assemble my card, and you can see how I plan to do it. So just because it looks too empty at the background, I'm going to use three of the stars in different sizes, and I'm going to use Versamark ink to stamp the background. And although I'm using Versamark ink to stamp them, I'm not going to do any embossing. I'm just going for the tone on tone look here. So I'm going to use my crocodile. I have also applied one gold eyelet. I'm going to add my thread. And I have used some foam squares at the back of the tag to stick it down. And now it's time to assemble all the little elements. To stick the star, I'm going to use at the back some glue, and I am using my glue pen, which I find really handy. I got it from one of the previous card kits, and I have used it so much. So I'm going to stick it that there. And now for the sentiment, I'm going to use some tiny foam squares at the back and then stick it on top of the star to add a little bit of dimension. Now for this card, I'm cheating a little bit, so I'm using a piece of a black cardstock that wasn't included in the kit. So I'm going to use a stencil now and lots of embossing powders. So I'm going to apply some Versamark ink through the stencil. And I am going to create a really striking card by using bright embossing powder colors on against a black cardstock, and you will see what I mean as I move on. So first I'm going to start with orange. I am going to apply it, and if you don't get the perfect embossing impression, like you get particles from your different embossing powders all over, it's not the end of the world, because really when you see fireworks at the sky, you really see lots of particles all over. So I got the orange there, and I am going to continue doing the same thing again and again, but each time I'm going to use another color of embossing powder. So I'm going with a kind of a rainbow color here, color theme here, and I am applying again my Versamark ink, and this time I'm going to apply red, and I'm going to continue doing so again and again. So here is the finished result, where I am heat embossing the green and the blue For the sentiment, I'm going to use a word die that says congratulations, that is from an older Simon Says stamp release. And if you don't have so many different colors of embossing powder, you can really recreate the same card by working on a white cardstock, but using your inks. Just use a dabber to go through the stencil with your different ink pads. For my card base, I have created a black card out of a cardstock that I have added from my stash. Remember that in the card kit there are only 4 cardstocks, and although I used to take the cardstocks from the kit and cut them in half to create 10 different cards, I could only make 8 out of them this time. So I added this one, and that's why I'm cheating actually. And you will see later on that I'm going to add one more. So I'm using my glue pen at the back of the word congratulations, and I'm going to stick it at the center. And let's move on to the next card. For this card, I'm going to use this beautiful embossed honeycomb. I'm going to cut out a panel, and then I'm going to use my distress ink. The color is Peacock Feathers, one of my favorite distress ink colors. And I'm going to apply some ink on this panel. This is going to bring up the design. And if you notice, I'm mainly staying heavy on one side of the panel, where I am going to darken it up a little bit with the distressing that was included in the kit. So now that the panel is ready, I'm going to go ahead and work on my focal points. I'm using some white cardstock, and I'm going to stamp some of the star constellations. I have actually stamped the larger star and 2 smaller ones. But you will see that I am going to use only 2 out of them. I'm applying some color after white embossing the stars to bring up the design and to add some bright colors. And once those are ready, I'm going to use my scissors and cut them out. While I am cutting, I'm staying just a hair away from the embossed lines. I did the exact same thing for the heart constellation. Again, I'm going to cut it out. Notice how I go just a hair outside the line. And these are going to be the focal points. I'm going to stick them directly on my panel by using foam squares at the back. You know I love dimension on my cards. And once that's there, I'm going to work on the sentiment. For the sentiment, I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink on my black cardstock. Heat set it and then cut it out. I have stamped the phrase that says "When we are together." I'm going to create a fishtail at the end, stick it down with foam squares at the back. And I always get asked what I do on the inside of my cards. Well, I usually leave them blank as they are so that I can write my message. But just because this has all those little dots at the end of the phrase, I'm going to stick it at the center of my card base. And on the inside, I'm going to stamp the rest of the sentiment. So I'm going to go with black ink, and I'm going to stamp "I see stars." And I still have plenty of room to write whatever personal message I want to. So now let's move on to the next card. For the next card, I have cut out a square out of the craft pattern papers. Again, I'm applying 2 different colors of distress ink to bring up the design. And I also want to cut out the star, so I'm measuring. And I'm going to work on the back of those pattern papers where there is no embossing. I am applying my Versamark ink, and I'm going to apply some embossing powder that is gold. I am planning to cut out the star out of gold so that it makes a big impact. Now I am going to heat set it. And I think that just because I wasn't crafting for a while since I was on vacation, I really missed crafting, and my favorite technique is embossing. So that's why I kept doing that again and again. So anyway, I am again doing the same technique that I did on a previous card. I am using my scissors to cut out, to cut around the star, just to separate it and create a different element. And this card is a great masculine card, and you will see at the end that it looks like a sheriff badge. So I'm going to stick that on a square card that's 4 1/4 by 4 1/4, and this is a card base from my stash. And I was planning to stick that at the center, but I thought that I needed to add a little bit more texture. So I'm going with this canvas. This is by Tim Holtz, and it's a self-adhesive. So I'm going to measure how much I want to cut out. I'm actually eyeballing it. And with my scissors, I'm going to cut out a square where I can fit inside the star. Now I'm going to peel off the back. And since it was too sticky, to make my life easier, I'm going to stick it on my craft mat. And I want to have that frayed edge all over. So I'm using my scissors to separate some of the threads. And once I'm happy with the look, I'm going to peel it off and stick it at the center of my square card. And just to make sure that the star is going to stay on its place, I am using glossy accents at the back. And notice how it didn't go all the way to the edges of the star, so that I get a little bit of dimension. I'm going to add the sentiment on the inside, since I have so much texture on the outside. And I went with the sentiment that said, "You are a star." For this card, I'm going to cut out two rectangle panels out of those two pattern papers. Both rectangles are exactly the same size. Again, I'm using the same technique of applying some distressing to bring up the texture, the design of this pattern paper. And I am going again for a masculine card. And this is going to be a birthday card. And since I have the first panel distressed, I'm going to do the same thing on the second one. I'm using the mini ink pad that was included in the kit. I'm going around the edges. And I'm going to blend in the vintage photo distressing that I have used on the first panel. And this is going to help bring everything together, really. And the idea here is to stick one on top of the other and fold one corner, like so. But just because you will be able to see the back of the pattern paper, I don't want that to be so bright. So again, I'm going to distress it. Same technique, only at the part where it's going to show. This is a great masculine card and also has a dimension, which I really love. Now, to make sure that this corner is going to stay there, I am going to use a brad. I'm picking up a gold brad, I believe, yes. And I'm just going to use my poke tool, create a hole there. Add the brad, and I'm going to use some tape adhesive at the back to stick one paper on top of the other. I really love this color combination for masculine cards. This is going to be a birthday card, so I have used this die-cut sentiment. You can use anything you have, really, and I'm going to apply some glue at the back using my glue pen. And you can really personalize this card. If you have number stickers, you can stick the years of the person you are giving the card to. So I'm going to add some details with my white gel pen. And I'm also going to add the dot for the I from the word birthday that I have forgot to stick down. And now I'm going to stick this directly on top of my card base. And let's move on to the last card for today. I am working on a white panel using 3 different stars from the stamp set. Again, I am stamping them with Versamark ink. I'm going to white emboss them. And once the stars were heat set, I'm going to reveal them by creating a night sky. You can see on screen the 3 different colors that I have used for my night sky. You can go as crazy as you want. You can see how beautiful it looks as it is now. But I decided to go ahead and darken it up a little bit more. But really anything works for the sky. Now, once I'm happy with how it looks, I'm going to add a little bit of black only at the edges to help my sky pop even more. The embossed areas resist distressing, but they will pop even more if you clean up when you are finished all those areas with a clean cloth, just like I'm doing here. So once that's ready, I'm going to work on my sentiment, and for that I'm going to stamp it on this speech bubble. I am going to nest on one of those cloud curves the word you. And this speech bubble comes from an older release by Simon Says Stamp. If you don't have this die, you can just cut it out, just draw a cloud and cut it out with your scissors. And for this card, I am going with a sentiment that says, dreaming of you. I used some tape adhesive at the back of this panel, and I'm going to stick it directly on top of my card base at the center. And then for the speech bubble, I'm going to add some foam squares at the back. I'm going to use my glue pen, and I'm going to add those little dots that come out of the cloud next to the word you. To finish off the card and to make it cuter, I have punched out a tiny little heart out of red cardstock, which I am going to stick just next to the word you. And I am going to apply some clear Wink of Stella glitter pen over the tiny little heart. So now let's take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I have created today. And I really loved this kit mainly because it inspired me to create some masculine cards, and I really don't have so many of them. I really believe that this color combination of dark blue and craft is the perfect color for guys. So now let's see my leftovers. So I have some stash builders, such as those mini distress ink pads, the die and the stencil, as well as the stamp set. And I have a few leftovers from the pattern papers and lots of the embossed pattern papers, the whites and the craft ones, to make even more cards. So here are some close-up photos of all the cards that I made today. And I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos where I am creating 10 cards using older Simon Says Stamp card kits. Thank you all for watching!